Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to crochet heart pattern shoulder bag, and for the materials, 100% acrylic DK yarn, 3.75mm crochet hook, stitch marker and a scissor. Let's begin. I wonder if God got a plan for everyone. I wonder if I could take a second run. Make a slip knot and chain 29. Double crochet into the second chain from the hook. And continue double crochet into each chain until the very end. At the end, chain 1, turn your work. Double crochet into the first 13 stitches. Once you get 13 stitches, chain 2 and skip 2 stitches. Double crochet into the next stitch. And continue double crochet into each stitch until the very end. Chain 1, turn your work. You must keep on chaining 1 before you turn your work, and that chain 1 does not count as a stitch. So that's why for every next row, you must always start working into the very first stitch from the hook. Row 3. Double crochet into this very first stitch from the hook. And continue double crochet into the next 10 stitches. Once you get 11 stitches, now chain 2 and skip 2 stitches. Make 2 double crochet into this chain 2 space. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches, double crochet into the next stitch, which is the third one. Now continue making double crochet into each stitch until the end. Chain 1, turn your work. Row 4, double crochet into the first 9 stitches. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches, 2 double crochet into this chain 2 space. Two double crochet into the next 2 stitches. Two double crochet into this chain 2 space. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches. Double crochet into the next stitch, which is the third one. Now continue making double crochet into each stitch until the end. Chain 1, turn your work. Row 5, double crochet into the first 7 stitches. Chain chain 2, skip 2 stitches, 2 double crochet into this chain 2 space, make double crochet into each stitch, these next stitches. Double crochet into this chain 2 space. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches. Double crochet into the next stitch, which is the third one. Now continue making double crochet into each stitch until the end. Row 5, chain 1, turn your work. Row 6, double crochet into the first 5 stitches. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches. 2 double crochet into this chain 2 space. Continue making 1 double crochet into each stitch. Make 2 double crochet into this chain 2 space. Chain 2. Skip 2 stitches and double crochet into the next stitch, which is the third one. And continue making double crochet into each stitch until the end. At the end, chain 1, turn your work. Row 7, double crochet into the first 5 stitches. Chain 2, skip this chain 2 space. Double crochet into the next stitch, which is the very first stitch from chain 2 space. Continue making double crochet into the next 5 stitches. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches. Double crochet into the next stitch. After chain 2, double crochet into the next stitch and continue making double crochet into each stitch for this next 5 stitches. Chain 2, skip this chain 2 space and make 1 double crochet into this very first stitch from chain 2 space. Continue making double crochet into each stitch until the end. Chain 1, then your work. Your work must start looking like this. Double crochet into the first 5 stitches. Make 2 double crochet into this chain 2 space. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches. And double crochet into the third stitch. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches. Double crochet into the next stitch. Make 2 double crochet into this chain 2 space. Double crochet in the next stitch. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches. Double crochet in the next stitch, which is the third one. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches again. Make 2 double crochet in this chain 2 space. Make double crochet into these last stitches. Make sure there are 5. Chain 1, turn your work. Row 9. Double crochet in the first 6 stitches. Do double crochet in this chain 2 space. Make 1 double crochet on top of this double crochet. Make 2 double crochet again in this chain 2 space. Continue making a double crochet on top of each stitch for these next 4 stitches. Make 2 double crochet in this chain 2 space. One more double crochet on top of this double crochet. Make 2 double crochet in this chain 2 space. Continue making 1 double crochet on top of each double crochet for these next stitches. Row 10. Make 1 double crochet in this very first stitch from the hook, as usual. And continue making 1 double crochet into every stitch until the end. So here we are at the end. Just make 1 double crochet into that last stitch, chain 1, turn your work. You can repeat row 10 as much as you want, but in my case, I'll only go for more last row. After row 10, just cut off the yarn. For your back strap, make a slip knot and chain 5. Single crochet into the second chain from the hook and continue making single crochet into each chain until the end. At the end, chain 1, turn your work. That chain 1 does not count as a stitch, that's why we are always starting working in the very first stitch from the hook. But this time around, we are only working in the back loop of each stitch. But in the last stitch, you must work in both loops. Continue making single crochet into each stitch back loop until you are satisfied with the length of your back strap, but just make sure that strap is long enough to cover all sides of your back. This is how your strap must be looking like. And just make sure it's long enough to cover all your back sides, and don't forget to leave a long tail for weaving it. Try to lay down both pieces flat and just try to see how your strap is fitting on your back. And just make sure both pieces are equal. If they are not equal, try to undo one of them that's not equal to the other one before you start joining them. To attach the strap to the back, start working with one piece at a time. For the joining yarn, you can use the same yarn color as the one you have used for your entire project, or you can use a different yarn color like the one I'm using. Mark the corner to avoid some unnecessary movements of your pieces. Join them with a single crochet and continue making single crochet across until you have fully attached your strap to the bag. You must do the same thing for the other piece as well. So to join the second part, you see how I have done the first one. This is how I have joined it. It looks really cool. I like it. I didn't know that this color could be matching so perfect like this. It turned out so perfect. And here is the stripe. So let's add our second piece to the bag. You see, this is supposed to be the right side and this is supposed to be the wrong side, but I want my bag to have like the wrong side out and the right side in, because I think this side, it just looks so pretty good than the outside one. So that's why I wanted to like to use it as my outside part of my bag. So to add it to the other side, just make sure it's fitting well and it's going well with the other piece. As you can see, don't mind about it, it's not that straight for now, but it's gonna look perfect at the end of the day. So, and just make sure your strap is not twisted. Make sure it's perfectly straight, because if it's twisted, then how are you gonna hang it on your shoulder and rock? See, I think it's already looking good. Oh, let me show you how the other side looks like. This is how it looks like. Comment below what you think about this two colors, and tell me if you are going to try making this tutorial, tell me which two colors are you going to use, or are you going to use only one plain color? If so, still just go ahead and tell me which color or which colors are you gonna use. So to join the other part, just make sure it's perfectly fitting like this, then just grab the yarn and do the same thing you've done for the other side. And once you come at this point, just make sure this side, since this side will also be attached, you can just grab this tail. Since that's the reason I didn't like cut it off, I have left a little bit of long tail, so I can like attach this strap to this side like this, because I can cut it off and use this other color to join. It's not gonna look that really pretty good, because it will be totally looking different from this side, the other side. So since I want it to look the same way as the other side, so I have left a long tail so I can join it to the other side once I have done attaching the second part. So just go ahead and complete your bag. I'll meet you once I'm done to show you how the finished product looks like. So the other thing I forgot to tell you when joining, just make sure when you're attaching this other piece to the strap, it must start in the very same row as the other piece. In this very same row, even here it must end in the same row, even at the end here it must end here in the same piece, because if happen one piece is ending in this row and the other one is ending like this, then your bag won't be looking good. So here I'm done to attach this strap to the bag. Just make sure this long tail is the one that you will use to attach it to this side. Must be attached this way. We can do so with our yarn needle. Make sure you are grabbing both loops. And pull them, although not way too tight. And weave in your ends after. This is how it should be looking like. This is how the other side looks like. So yeah, this is our braid.